Hello everyone! Thanks for coming back for another episode of What's What. Today, we will expand on a subject we touched on previously, and that is how electricity operates within and around the human body. No. Anatomy and electricity can sometimes mix, sometimes not, but it's all science. Wait! Anatomy is considered science, right? Of course it is! Before we get into the details, do not forget to like and subscribe below. So we know that metals, especially copper and aluminum, are great conductors of electricity. But liquids and gas can also conduct electricity, though they are a bit more resistant. This is particularly true with water, the main component of the human body. See what we are getting at here. The average adult body is made up of around 65% of water. So if you multiply your weight by 0.65, you'll know your water weight. But it must be noted that water is not distributed evenly throughout the body. 1% of total water weight is in the ivory of teeth, and there is near 90% in blood. Apart from blood, our organs hold the highest concentration of water, including the heart and the brain. But here is the interesting part. Water itself does not conduct electricity because of its lack of free electrons. What makes current flow possible is the contained sediments and minerals that ionize within its molecules. Sodium, calcium, potassium, and magnesium are minerals found within our bodies. These ions have a very specific electric charge, and our body's cells use them to generate small amounts of electricity. Our bodies conduct electricity indeed. Instead of considering electricity as solely dangerous, we should acknowledge that electricity also plays a crucial role in organ function and maintenance. Our organs use electricity to send tiny signals to and from one another and guarantee vital bodily function. For example, our body cells generate currents and allow the heart muscles to contract and inflate at exactly the right time. The different parts of the heart work in synchronization and adapt to circumstance, like per se, sending more oxygen for the muscles when we work out. The value of the tiny electric currents that our bodies carry can actually be measured, and the device used to measure them is actually pretty cool. With this device, also known as an ECG, your doctor can analyze electric currents throughout our body and identify potential heart disease. Here is a good example of how electric currents flow through our nerves and how nerves control our muscles to raise our hands, to bend our knees, even to hit subscribe to What's What. Hehe, sorry. Our neurons are connected by synapses, or a junction between two nerve cells, and currents circulate as impulses through these synapses, usually around 100 meters per second. So you ask, how is electricity lethal to the human body if our cells already transmit electrical currents to maintain bodily function? Science is never simple, is it? Actually, the answer to this question is quite simple. The electric signals traveling through our body are nothing in comparison to the generated electricity flowing around us in appliances. To put things into perspective, the electric resistance of our nerve fibers is 100 million times greater than that of a copper wire. And the membranes that enclose our cells are a million times more permeable to electric current than the sheath of an adequate electric cable. Exposure to high levels of electricity can cause heart failure, burns, loss of muscle control, can disrupt the electrical signals within the body, and also cause paralysis. Other hazardous exposures to electricity can include electric shock, psychological damage, physical burns, neurological damage, and ventricular fibrillation. The first thing that comes to mind is shock, when a current passes throughout the body and delivers a wide range of effects, from harmless to painful to deadly. That is why, when dealing with electricity, it is always important to take the proper safety precautions, like we discuss here. There are many references online that provide information on shock levels and how our exposure to levels can vary. But effects of exposure also depend on the amount of current, the path taken by the current, shock duration, and frequency. In previous episodes, we learned that conductors dissipate heat when transmitting electrical currents. This is not the case for the human body. When we encounter severe exposure to electrical current, the result is burned tissue. What some don't know is that the damage of electrical burns can actually be more severe than that caused by an open flame. This makes sense if you consider the current's path. Electricity can touch tissue well beneath the skin, like internal organs. Electricity can also overload our nervous system, altering reactions, signals, and causing disruption in muscle control. This only happens when muscles are exposed to external shock. Sadly, the victim cannot do anything about it. Our body is overwhelmed by the electricity, and it is not only skeletal muscles that are affected. The diaphragm, which controls the heart and lungs, can also be stopped when exposed to high electric currents, causing asphyxiation or cardiac arrest. Yeah, we know, it's not an easy subject, but again, it's important to know of risks. That way we can prevent them. Remember, safety first. Electricity is malleable, but it must be handled with care. Consult professionals, put on those rubber gloves, check your fuses, and never stop learning of new ways to keep hazard away. Remember, the human body is made up of 65% water. Ions within its water conduct electricity. Our bodies need electricity to operate their vital organs, but are not as conductive as other materials. External electric shock is dangerous to us and can cause serious health effects. Safety measures are absolutely essential when dealing with electricity. If ever in question, consult a professional. That about wraps it up for this episode of What's What. Remember, electricity is everywhere, but we must be aware of its uses and functions within us and all around. Got any more ideas of how electricity and anatomy mix? Feel free to drop a comment below. Until next time!